Welcome to part 2 of Trainz, the evolution. We start again with a picture of video part 1 as to pick up the story again and with an overview of the total Trainz map. In part 1 I have promised to come back on some details. I keep my promises. And so we start with a round-trip flight in the mountains and above the city of Zutphen. We fly around the snowy top of the Mont Sud and have a nice view over the Rhine Valley. Here we fly above the city of Zutphen and its not existing but lively container port. Here, probably, also a lot of coke is entering our country. It seems that especially the pilots in this plane take a lot of coke. With doubtful results. You will see that later on. Then we fly into the direction of the canyon between Zutphen and Deventer, with its beautiful waterfalls. Viewers who know the Netherlands also know that our country is as flat as a pancake. Not for nothing we are called the Netherlands. Thus we have no canyon at all. Viewers that have not seen part 1 will think now that fellow is totally idiot. Well, that's a little bit correct, but in part 1 I explained how everything fits. When we leave the canyon, in the distance we see the city of Deventer, the central point of the map. The village Kolmsgate, over which we are flying now, has a cruise port, Fort Lauderdale of the Netherlands. In part 1 I spoke about synchronic cows, but there are also synchronic people. Here you see a couple of gentlemen together, making ridiculous but synchronous moves. However, if you say that this is a music conductor's course, it is suddenly believable. Let's continue to the logging of trees. Several loggers are working hard with zero results, except one who is doing nothing. And that one is chopping the one after the other. He must have a secret. If there is a tree chopped, in only 1 second there is a full-grown new one. That's what we call making production. Those who have seen part 1 know that there is a route from Zutphen to Apeldoorn via the German Rhine Valley. But there is also a route via the island of Ameland, which we choose now. Here we drive on a flyover and later we will dive into a tunnel under the sea. You will see that the salary level of the residents on this route is quite different. It's just like in reality. We stop at the station of the island of Ameland, where at the same time a French train Grande Vitesse is leaving. By the way, Ameland has no station at all and is only reachable by ferry. Ameland has a beautiful beaches where many tourists enjoy themselves. Another promise was to follow the KLM train from the city of Apeldoorn to the airport station. In reality, Apeldoorn has no airport at all. When we arrive at the airport, you can also see unloading and loading of passengers. The doors open and close, which is a nice effect. But the passengers are sort of teleported from the train to the platform and back. There is also a helicopter connection between the airport and Apeldoorn. We will follow such a flight for a short while. We are now going to make a flight with a KLM City Hopper from Apeldoorn via Zutphen and then return through the Rhine Valley. As I said earlier, the pilots here are coke sniffers, with very dangerous results. When they are high in their heads but low on the ground, they don't stick to whatever rules. This leads regularly to the most dangerous results. Two planes on the runway is quite normal, or landing while another one is departing, and even sometimes they fly through each other. Let's be happy that it are all pixels. I already fired some pilots, but they are not impressed at all. I ask your attention for a speed sign hanging in the air, telling the pilot what speed he should fly. I forgot to interchange that with an invisible sign. Here it comes. Below us, again the island of Ameland. Now we fly over Zutphen with its container Coke port, and we enter the Rhine Valley south of Koblenz in Germany. Yes, we are flying fast. These aircraft are adapted locomotives running on invisible tracks on a high level. In building mode of the program, you can see such tracks, but not in the play mode. Watch the coming landing, all consequences of sniffing coke. In part 1, I mentioned it already, ships on the River Rhine. We follow a short while one of the ships. That again are adapted locomotives running on invisible tracks. In part 1, when we crossed the Golden Gate, I mentioned that some cruise ships sail under the bridge, but that those ships were too far away. Lots of you will have thought, yeah, a nice excuse. Well, here they are, but now there is no train within view distance. I mentioned also synchronic cows, but this was not so clear on the video. Here you can see this better. Probably new batteries inserted at the same time. Now we follow the train from Twello to the non-existing fishing harbor. According to me, this is the smallest locomotive of the Dutch railways. It has also controls on the outside. They call it the SICK. We leave Deventer with an old German rail coach heading to the island of Texel, which is connected to the mainland by some beautiful bridges. It is a very popular tourist destination, and as you can see, the parking at the beach is crowded. Moreover, you see the effects of global warming. The Dutch Texel is full of palm trees. Now we leave Deventer in the direction of Heino. The fantasy of the builder went on tilt again, as we have to drive through a real desert. At the center is a small lake, and thus a beautiful oasis developed. I apologize for the bad sound quality of the train. Besides the quality, it is not fast either. In the distance you see birds circling in the air. If we have passed by, they will dive on a dead camel laying on the red spot. When we leave the tunnel, we enter the station of the village of Heino, and in a green Eldorado. Heino seems a bit of a ghost town, without any life. That's my fault, of course, because I have no one placed down there. But they are also mad at me. If you look at the map of the Netherlands, after Deventer, first comes Raalte and then Heino. And not the other way round. And the people here do not accept that and protest it by leaving. And let's be honest, it's not smart of me. Here we arrive in the little town of Raalte. These people did not mind the changing of places and are simply present. As a fact, Raalte was the first town built by me in this plan. The mayor wanted to use his influences how to build the town. But I did not accept that. He has been promoted to the North Pole. We are now entering undeveloped land. Only grass was seeded here. It must have its time. However, I show it just to give you an idea how much work it is to make a nice world out of it. It asks a lot of patience and you must really enjoy doing it as to continue. We now are approaching the station of the village of Nijverdal. The mayor gave me a free hand in the development and the results are astonishing. Nijverdal has made a stormy development. A wonderful little town with its own international airport. We follow the train which connects Nijverdal center with the airport. We drive through a wealthy area with many bankers and pilots, of course. Also, we have to thank all professional and non-professional developers who made all these attributes that one can use in the routes and plans. Simply fantastic. We also follow the freight train on its way to the industrial area behind the airport. As I did not develop the industry in this plan, nothing of interest happens there. Here also I see for the first time that there is cargo in the car. This is the Nijverdal slaughterhouse, where we just delivered our synchronic cows. We finalize our train journey with a cozy ride through the sometimes picturesque Nijverdal. Nijverdal has a regular air connection to Apeldoorn, which is situated on the other side of the overall plan. We fly with a Boeing 737 of American towards Apeldoorn for a final overview over the world of trains. Below us we see Raalte without its mayor. Then follows the depopulated Heino. We fly over the desert where the raptors are busy with their dead camel. Here is Deventer again as Trainz center. Flying over our world, you can of course see that I did not dress a lot of ground, as you don't see that from the Trainz. Above the canyon on our way to Zutphen. Then again we are flying to the airport of Apeldoorn, where we will make a safe landing. These were my two movies about the hobby program Trainz. I am convinced that you have a good impression of the possibilities. I hope that you have enjoyed watching, just as much as I have enjoyed making it. Finally, I thank you for your patience, if you still can hear these last words.